This is the Schmo with the pro, Bevon Lewis, 6-0. You're fighting middleweight. You're coming off winning Dana White's Contender Series. Now in the bright lights here at the Forum. How does it feel?
Feels great, buddy. You know, the Contender Series, the lights was pretty bright there, too. You know, I was right in front of the boss doing my job, so I feel really good about this one.
A big TKO victory against a tough guy, Alton Cunningham. That was a big victory for you.
Yeah, I did a lot of work going into that one. You know, I knew exactly what to do to beat him, and I went out there and executed properly.
Now you're fighting up against a UFC veteran, Uriah Hall. He's got a lot of experience under his belt. What do you have in store for a veteran like him?
So a guy with a lot of experience, that means he got a lot of wins, also a lot of losses, more losses than I have wins. So I also feel like I have the game plan to beat him. When it comes Saturday, my job is to go beat him down.
How was your travel experience changed with moving from Las Vegas here to L.A.? To any family accommodations that had to be changed? Did John Jones cover any of those flight expenses for you?
All right, so pretty much, you know, you get the phone call about going to Los Angeles, and you're like, really? Wow, how? You know, is the fight still on? Honestly, a lot of things got messed up, but I wanted to fight. I couldn't imagine saying, yo, I'm not going to get to fight the 29th and going into the new year and I ain't get the UFC debut. So, you know, at the end of the day, it comes with the job. I'm a man. I figure out how to do my things no matter how difficult it is. And I got my job done. I'm here in Los Angeles. I'm happy to be a part of UFC.
Yeah.
I feel like it's history. So
fighting in the house that Magic Johnson built over in the Forum.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I was born in Cali, too. Now a lot of people don't know that, but I left there as a child and moved around the states, state to state for a while. Now I'm back here in L.A., so, you know, maybe it's just a sign.
Now, when you look at the versatility in the middleweight division, you had a guy like Calvin Gastelum come in as a welterweight, move up into the middleweight. He's fighting for the belt over in Australia. You have guys like Israel Adesanya coming from a kickboxing background. Where do you stack up against some of the big boys that you're here right now?
Right there in the top 10. I got to be there. You know, I'm fighting Uriah Hall, and after that fight, after that fight, I feel like everyone else will be on notice. You know, I got to go do my job again. As far as the champion, who's the champ? Robert Whittaker.
Robert Whittaker.
I feel like they are 170 pounders, you know, not full middleweights, but, you know, they just came up to the weight class and right now they're holding it down. But I think right now I'm going to bring the fire. If not, I am the fire that's going to ignite everybody to start doing, you know, being real 85ers, you know, making it interesting again. I'm here to make it. I am interesting, and once we get that cracking, the whole world will find out.
Who do you enjoy watching the most in the UFC right now that you model a lot of moves after, or that you're like, I take this and I can put it on, spin it off to my own moves, you know?
Yeah, there's a guy out there we might last. I mean, I like watching Bones. I like watching Israel. I like watching lightweights, lightweights, heavyweights, but there's no specific person. I feel like in order to be the best mixed martial arts, you got to watch all aspects, so... You know, get little pieces from everybody, figure myself out and then, you know, assert myself the way I'm supposed to.
And lastly, we'll get you out of here on this. What's your prediction for the fight?
What is it? Just a complete beatdown. I mean, I'm the man for the job, so complete beatdown. However, wherever it goes, beatdown.
Bevon Lewis, best of luck to you. Bright lights, you're used to it.
Appreciate it, Smoke.